say, all have broken the law. I think we all have. I think if all of us got convicted for every crime we ever committed, then we'd all have a criminal record a mile long, except for a rare few. I'm not suggesting we're all murderers, we're all not. But we've all committed crimes. I bet almost everyone has stolen. I know I have. A lot of people have drove drunk, but very few are caught and tried. Just with drunk driving alone, you could get at least half the people out there a criminal record. So it's stupid to be hard on crime. A lot of people just get lucky and they don't deserve it. Once some of us were protesting how the state of Wisconsin funds the criminal justice system but not education. We were thinking it should fund education because that's important. Some hardened crime people got upset. It doesn't really make sense when you think about it. If you're hardened crime, why would you want more money to go to helping the criminals? This one dude I was arguing with was really a cocky idiot. I said to him, have you ever drove drunk? He said, yes. And then he paused, but I haven't been caught. So it's clear he's no different than these other people. Drunk driving is one of the worst crimes out there. So if you commit drunk driving, and that's many of you, you deserve to be thrown in prison. So shut up on your hardened crime nonsense. Some innocent people are convicted no matter what some people try to tell us. People like Ann Coulter even come out and say, no, innocent people have been convicted. I think you have to be awfully psychotic to believe that. It's really cool to be tough on crime and act otherwise. But you're psychotic if you do so. Innocent people are convicted. Innocent people are rotting in jail. One speaker Federation Without Television had was this dude named Whistleblower Courier. He made a good point when I was talking to him. He said, people get motivated when it's their acts to be ground. Referring to the fact people don't care about when somebody else has an axe to grind because it doesn't affect them. That's a sad way it is. If you are innocently convicted, and I hope it happens to a lot of these tough on crime people because that would humble their cocky selves, then you really care about justice being carried out. Happens to someone else, who cares? A lot of people have that attitude and that really sucks. That's rotten. Critics of our criminal justice system say our criminal justice system really sucks at rehabilitating people. And thus we should change it so it actually rehabilitates people. The saying is people come out worse than when they went in. People shouldn't rot in prison. Because, like others have pointed out, almost everyone who's in prison is going to come out eventually. Even some people convicted of homicide are going to come out. That's the way it is. So even if we don't care a lick about the criminals themselves, hopefully we care about the state of society. And it's no good when people rot to such a degree they get worse in prison and then come out. A prime example of this was that dude in Texas. He was put in prison for the charge of burglary. I was charged with that. Although the difference was he actually did it and I didn't. And soon enough I wasn't charged with that anymore. Who knows what would have happened if I was thrown in a maximum security prison because of it. I probably wouldn't have at such a young age. But it just goes to show, when we think we're so much different than those awful criminals, a lot of cops will say, "I'm better." You're not. You're an idiot. I have even heard more honest people point out the cops actually are the most rotten, and they break the law more than the others. So they're a bunch of hypocrites. This dude in Texas went into prison as a common criminal. That's not a good way to be. But he turned into something far, far worse. He, like many other white prisoners, faced a dilemma in prison. Prison is a very brutal place. In order to protect themselves, people form gangs. These gangs are often formed along racial lines. You have a black gang, a Cuban gang, a Puerto Rican gang, a Mexican gang, maybe a Native American gang, maybe an Arabic gang. If you're white, there can be the option of the white supremacist gang. If you're racially tolerant, you may say, "I'm not going to join that gang." But guess what? If you don't join it, you're not going to have the protection of the white supremacist gang. So all those other gangs are going to beat you up. You have no one to help you. Plus, the white supremacist gang is going to beat you up. He, in order to survive, joined the white supremacist gang. And when he came out, he was far worse than a common criminal. He dragged that guy in one of the most notorious hate crimes of the 90s. Another failure of our criminal justice system. We typically don't think of dentists as demagogues, but they can be. They can rant and rave about teeth rotting, just like other demagogues rant and rave. They can appeal to our emotions and passions, just like other demagogues. It may not be as serious of a matter, but they surely do the job. Sometimes dentists come to schools and show kids pictures of what happens if they don't brush their teeth. That causes the kids to get afraid. "I better brush my teeth, they're going to turn all rotten." When I was young, I even was in this school play about teeth.